Hello guys, welcome back. In this video, we'll talk about ternary operator. So if you have used ternary operator in C, so you might be familiar with those operators in Java also. So Java also supports ternary operator. So what exactly ternary operator is? So let's say I have a variable which is I here with the value of I is 1, and I have J value which is 5. Okay. And let me print the value of J. So if I print the value of J here, and if I run this, so answer is 5, right? But let's say I want to change the value of J depend upon the value of I. So I can simply say if I is equal to 1, I can say J is equal to 6, else J is equal to 7. So now it will print 6 or 7. So it will check, okay, the I value is 1, which simply means this condition will be true. It will change the value of J and will make it 6. So when you print this, the value of J will be 6, right? So if I run this, the answer is 6. But how to convert this into a complex code? Okay, how to make it more, in one line. So what you can do is, instead of writing this statement here, which is if-else statement, you can actually use a ternary operator. Now how to use ternary operator? We can simply say J equal to. Now, what is the value of J? Is it 6 or 7? So we can simply check if J is equal to I is equal to 1. If this condition goes true, so it will print 6. Otherwise, it will print 7. Cool. So instead of writing this line here, we can simply specify this thing. So if this condition is true, it will execute the part after this question mark. If this condition is false, it will go directly after the colon, which is 7. Okay, and if I run this now, again the answer is 6. But let's say if I change the value of 1 as 4, okay, and now if I run this, so the answer is 7, right? So this ternary operator is just a replacement for if-else. But hold on, is it ternary operator really a replacement for if-else? Let's try to find out with the next example. So for now, just remember, you can replace your if-else condition with ternary. And we'll try to prove it wrong. So let me remove this part and this also. Now, once you got the idea about ternary operator, let me write a code here. Okay, and this code goes in something in this way. So let's say I have an object. Okay, so let's say if I have an object here, which is, let's say, O1. Okay. I will say obj1, and I have something called, I will say obj1, and if, let me check, if it is true, so directly I'm going for the condition which is true, if it is true, then obj1 is equal to new integer, and will pass a value, let's say 1, or let's say, but we pass value 10. Cool. So if my condition is true, it will assign the value 10, which is integer, and in else part, what I will do is I will say obj1 equal to new integer, and we can pass, not this time we'll go for a double, so we'll say double, and let me pass 20 15.0. Cool. So I have this integer which is 10, and if it is false, if this condition is false, it will print double. But anyway, since we are writing true, it will always execute the first part. But let's see what's the output. And let me print the value of obj1 here. And if you print the value of obj1 here, it will print 10, of course, right? It's because we are assigning a value which is integer. Now, if you try to convert this code into ternary operator. So since we said that ternary operator is just a replacement for if-else, let me use one more object here, which is obj2, okay? And let's try to write this in ternary operator. So how to write this? We have to say obj2 equal to, if it is true, that's we know, it will be always true, question mark. If it is true, we have to return new integer with value 10, colon, new double with value 15.0. Now question arises, what will be the output of obj2? So let me just run this, and obj2. Now if your if this ternary operator is just a replacement for if else, it should print 10, right? Let's see. If you run this, the answer is 10.0. So for the if else output, the answer is 10. For ternary operator is 10.0. It's simply because whenever you work with ternary operator, it will check the type of both the values. So this one also and this one also. Whichever is maximum, it will occupy that type. So by default, this 10 here, this integer part here, gets converted into a double value. And that's why the output you are getting here is 10.0. Cool. So that's the use of ternary operator, and that's the trick of using ternary operator. So thanks for watching this video, and do subscribe, do share my videos. Thank you.